Hello there. Very good morning. Giulio Cerroni is joining us today, Chief Executive Officer there from IXICO, because plenty to discuss given that this morning you issued your half year to March 22 results and of course your trading update as well. So we're going to go through all of that and much, much more. So despite a decline in first half top line revenues, you do expect to materially exceed full year profits expectations. What are the details behind this improved outlook? And a very good morning.
Yes, good morning to you as well, Katie, and thank you. So clearly, by our standards we've set in recent years, where we've routinely delivered top line growth of 20% plus, reporting decline in revenues is not what we're about. However, these first half revenues were in line with our management expectations and fully anticipated. And there's a direct consequence of the previously announced early termination of client contracts that we announced earlier in the year, around about 12 months ago, from our largest client. And that was basically a client decision to cease dosing patients in two clinical trials for a Huntington's disease investigational new drug that they contracted IXICO to support. Now, these were the pivotal trial actually was the world's largest phase three Huntington's disease trial, and was a transformational event for IXICO and demonstrated that we could win and also execute very successfully large phase three studies. And then that's important because previous to that, I think IXICO was primarily seen perhaps as an early phase clinical trial CRO. So that was an important milestone for IXICO. Now, clearly, having been a major contributor to our growth in recent years, we've been managing the impacts of that decision by the client. And so we've been very focused on winning new contracts, but also I'm very pleased with the balance that we've gotten in terms of making investments in the business to strengthen our technology, our scientific offering, which includes £1 million investment in our cloud-based Azure next generation imaging platform, which is well advanced now. All of that together, that management and that sort of balanced approach to management investment to those long-term projects, we're delighted with being able to deliver a very robust first half performance of £500,000 in EBITDA and a cash inflow of £200,000 for the first half. Just finished off in terms of the reason for the outlook going forwards, it's partly because of that very robust first half EBITDA performance, but also because we've been successful in winning new contracts. And we expect those new contracts, many of which are with new clients for IXICO, to start coming through in the second half performance, so that we expect a much stronger second half versus the first half in relation to top line revenues. So those two things combined, we've raised our the profit guidance to more than £1.2 million for the full year.
And tell us more about why you are so excited about this particular HD Huntington's disease consortia contracts.
Yeah, so in a nutshell, it's the start of what we hope is something that will continue to grow in the coming years. So this is a consortia of four founding members, of which IXICO is one, and we have a charitable foundation with a large Huntington's disease patient clinical trial imaging data set and two biopharma companies. So we've been granted rights of use of this very large imaging data set, and using our new IXICO AI analytics platform, we're now undertaking a retrospective analysis of that data set for the benefit of the consortium members. And that will support their existing clinical trial programs, but also provide potential new academic findings for the broader Huntington's disease community. And this framework, as I said, the framework of the agreement allows additional members to join the club, if you like, by contracting with IXICO and having additional analysis undertaken on the data set, as well as benefiting from access to the analysis that's been done by the previous members of the club, of the consortia. And so in summary, it allows additional new potential revenues to IXICO because it allows new members to join this consortia. And we expect that to foster long-term engagement with new clients for IXICO, which should stand us in good stead for many years to come.
All right, let's maybe look further forwards now. Can you maybe describe what challenges and indeed opportunities you see for IXICO as you kind of look to your future investment program to support long-term growth?
Yeah, so our investment program is going to be aimed at further differentiating IXICO's AI analytics offering to address the biopharma's focus on enhancing precision and efficiency in clinical trials. And that's why we exist, is to enable them to achieve that. And the opportunity and reason for our focus on neuroscience is that neurological research is the second largest development area for new drugs after oncology. Dementia is still the only major cause of death that we can't slow down or cure. There's a $1.3 trillion worldwide healthcare cost reported for dementia. That's only going to get bigger. And it's going to get bigger because of an aging population. So projections are that there's going to be a tripling of people with dementia to over 130 million people between 2015 and 2050. So that's the long-term outlook and the reason for our focus on neuroscience and our focus on our investment programs. On the risk side, just like to remind your listeners that developing drugs takes a long time, costs a lot of money, and is difficult, especially in neuroscience. So, for example, clinical development success rates are a good point in case. So the likelihood of a phase one clinical trial drug achieving approval is under 8%. And in neurological drug development, it's around about 6%. So you can see those are the numbers that to back up the fact that drug development is difficult. And also that drug developments take a long time in neurological disease development, on average 11 years. So these are long plays, but with a very high return for the successful drugs that do make their way to market. So what that means for us and for all CROs is that short-term trading can be impacted by these industry dynamics, as we've seen in the past 12 months. But consequently, it's really important that companies have the balance sheet to support investment to build scale and be better able to manage the risk and downside of pharma clients deciding to terminate their clinical development programs earlier than anticipated. Now, in the case of IXICO, again, this will all be in the numbers that are out there, but we do have a very strong balance sheet. We have a very strong cash position, and that allows us to make those balanced investments that I talked about earlier in relation to not just short term, but longer term, and being able to capture as much of this opportunity that I've described.
Okay. And how would you like to summarize the outlook for IXICO?
So we're a technology company, very scientifically orientated and focused on neuroscience. We provide high valued services that allow improved data-driven insights to enable the design and efficient clinical trials, basically, focused on this neuroscience area, so that we can increase the likelihood of approval of safe and effective therapies to market sooner. That's the outlook for IXICO, to do that well. As I said, we're well-financed, we're debt-free, and we can support our investment program to execute on more clinical trials with our five-year growth strategy focused around precision analytics. And the final point I'd like to make to readers really is, and listeners, is that our current market valuation sits at around about 19 million, which equates to around about an enterprise valuation of 1.5 times. So I'll leave you to investors to determine whether they feel that's a fair valuation and whether the short-term impacts have been perhaps considered in that valuation. But the long-term view and the mid-term view for IXICO is that there is a high unmet clinical need for new drugs in neuroscience. This isn't going to go away because of COVID. And in fact, it's only going to get bigger with that aging population.
Okay, Giulio Cerroni, thank you very much indeed, the Chief Executive Officer there from IXICO.
Thank you.